So we're going to do some new sets of problems because I want to show you how you can connect solving equations with solving inequalities. All right, so we already know how to do this. Subtract 3 on both sides, you get -8, and then check your answer. You can do the same here with subtracting a 3 from both sides and solve, and then integral notation, graphical solution. This is what we've been doing. We're going to show you a new way of solving inequalities. It's not as necessary to do that second method in simple problems like these, but it's another additional tool you're building so that if you encounter a difficult inequality, you can do that. So in your next class, perhaps, you might have more difficult inequalities to solve, and maybe this method will come in handy. So take a look. You can take the inequality and just forget about the less than sign. Just make it equal to sign, solve like you would an equation. And then what happens? You end up with x equals -8. So -8 is a number on a number line. And we know the original inequality is less than. Less than means you are not going to be allowed any numbers here that make x plus 3 exactly equal to -5. -8 makes it exactly equal to -5. So -8 cannot be part of your solution. All right, well, if that's the case, then I'm going to try a number below -8. This is called a test point. Let's say -10. Plug it into the original inequality and see what happens. -10 plus 3 is smaller than -5. -7 is smaller than -5. That's a true statement, which means -10 is part of my solution, isn't it? So -10 is part of my solution. Let's take a number to the other side of -8, say -7. -7 plus 3 is -4. -4 is smaller than -5. That's a false statement. So -7 is not part of the solution, but -10 is. In fact, look, if you take any number that is smaller than -8, -9, -15, -8.5, plus 3 is going to be a number smaller than -5. So every number below -8 is going to make this statement a true statement, and so all of that is your solution. So what's this second method? Take the inequality, so forget about the inequality sign, put equal to sign, solve, then check if you're allowed to have equal to or not. So whatever number you get from the equation, plug them back in here. If it's a true statement, it's part of your solution. And then the number line is divided into parts, below -8, above -8. So it's going to be divided into parts, test 1 point from each of the parts. Wherever the inequality has a true value, it's part of your solution. False value is not part of your solution. So same thing, 3x minus 5 equals 0, solve for x. And so 5/3 is the point on the number line, right? What if I wanted to solve this inequality, less than or equal to 0? Well, look what happens. So I have x less equals 5/3, which is all that. So I can do it that way like I used to. Or in the second method, what will I do? The number line is now broken into two parts, above and below. 5/3 is included in our solution because you're allowed to have equal to 0. 5/3 makes it exactly equal to 0. So that's in the solution. Now do a test point. So let's do some test point. So let's pick a point below 5/3. What do you want to pick? All right, 0 is good. So 3 times 0 minus 5 is -5, and -5 is less than or equal to 0, so true. So that is part of your solution. What about that? Say pick 2. And that's not a true statement. So that would be your solution. And integral notation would be negative infinity to 5/3 with a square bracket 5/3 because 5/3 is included. Okay, so the second method will be useful to you in some occasions, but we'll see very soon actually. All right, so look, when I have absolute value, how do I undo absolute value? Well, I need to resort back to the meaning of absolute value. Because nothing you can do here to separate algebraically the 4 out, because it's stuck inside the absolute value symbol. So what do we do? Well, think about what absolute value means. Absolute value 5 means distance from 0. So distance from 0 of what gives you 5? So 5 is 5 units away from 0, and also negative 5 is 5 units away from 0. So x minus 4 has no choice but to be exactly equal to negative 5 or 5. And then add 4 to both sides, and you'll get a negative 5 plus 4 is negative 1, 5 plus 4 is 9. So x equals negative 1 or 9 are solutions to this absolute value equation. Well, here's negative 1, here's 9. Those are your solutions for this equation here. We plotted them. All right, what if I wanted to solve this inequality? Remember, we cannot get rid of that 4, so how do we get rid of it? Well, here the second method is going to come in handy because there is no other way of solving, is there? All right, so let's solve the equation, and that will give you negative 1 and 9. Now what? Look at the number line. There is part below negative 1, between negative 1 and 9, and above 9. Okay, so now we have to just take test points and check which solutions are going to work. So why should I remove negative 1 and 9? Because it's strictly greater than. You cannot have, so if you include them, that means they're going to make it exactly equal to 5, and equal to 5 is not allowed. You want greater than 5. All right, so those are not included. So let's do our test point. We need a point from here, say negative 2. Absolute value negative 2 minus 4 is absolute value negative 6 is 6. 6 is bigger than 5, which is a true statement. So all of this is part of solution. All right, let's pick a number here, say what? 0. Absolute value 0 minus 4 is absolute value negative 4, which is 4. And 4 is bigger than 5 is a false statement. So that's not part of the solution. Let's pick a number from here. And you can see it's a true statement. Now, how do I know just by picking one test point that all these points are going to work? Because look, if I pick negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, if you subtract 4, negative 1 minus 4 is negative 5, so everything here is going to be smaller than negative 5, and absolute value of that is going to be bigger than 5, because negative 6, negative 7, negative 8, those are all numbers smaller than negative 5, and their absolute value is bigger than 5. Same thing will happen here. No matter what number you pick, if you subtract a 4 from any number between negative 1 and 9, you are always going to get a number smaller than 5. If you pick a number bigger than 9 and you subtract 4 from it, you'll always get a number bigger than 5, and its absolute value will also be bigger than 5. So there is more complicated reasons for why you should just take one test point, but it's beyond the scope of this class. So for right now, it's still believable. You can see no matter what number I pick, minus 4 absolute value of that number is bigger than 5. You can see. So this will be our interval notation then. Negative infinity to negative 1, 9 to infinity, they're all open because you have holes and infinity is never included. All right, so again, we want absolute value 4, so 3x minus 5 is going to have to be exactly equal to negative 4 or exactly equal to 4. We solve that, and those are the two solutions we got. Try that inequality on your own now. Use method 2. Pause the video here and solve. I'll give you a few moments. So we are going to set it equal to solve. You get those 2 points. Should we include them or not? They are included because you have less than or equal to 4. We need test points below 1/3, between 1/3 and 3, and beyond 3. So if I pick 0, look what happens. 3 times 0 is 0. Absolute value negative 5 is 5, and 5 less equals 4 is a false statement, isn't it? All right, pick a number between 1/3 and 3, say 1. 3 times 1 is 3, 3 minus 5 is negative 2, absolute value of negative 2 is 2, which is less than or equal to 4. It's a true statement, so all of these are going to be your solutions. Pick a number above 3, say 4. And false. 7 is less equals 4 is false, so this is not part of solution. So this is your solution. So interval notation would be square bracket 1/3, comma 3 square bracket. Square bracket because 1/3 and 3 are included. Try these on your own.